YouTube, I just thought I should make a video because this morning I watched a TED Talk on adaptability. You know, which is great. TED Talks are awesome. I watch them all the time.
Thank you.
why. But I'm thinking maybe I can duct tape this thing. That's my plan. Duct tape to the rescue. I will duct tape this up. And then it probably won't hold enough to do the monitoring. Like maybe a lifeboat. But I should probably not try that. But if I can duct tape it, and then if it'll at least hold it till Monday, then they'll have to cut away to duct tape and stuff. But, oh well. Yeah, I think I might be able to do that. Alright, so now I gotta find some duct tape to put on the couch with all my other work on stuff while sitting down. Oh, the problem is the dun dun dun. The maintenance man was here earlier, and I was like just finishing up in the restroom, and I didn't have time to put a new diaper on. I just got cleaned up and stuff, just cathed and all that. So I was like, okay, I just cathed, so I'm not gonna have to worry about it anyway. So I just like let him in and stuff. But now I'm gonna have to get. I should probably do that before I sit on the couch. But before I do that, then I need to get duct tape over here because I'm gonna attempt to jury rig this footrest. Keep me going in the meantime. So in the meantime, you know, that's life. Like sometimes life just changes, you know. Sometimes plans for the day change. Sometimes instead of cleaning my apartment, which would be difficult to do with my footrest about to fall off and drag on the floor and all that stuff. But actually, I still think I'm gonna clean a little bit later. Still think so. But in the meantime, right now, hold on. I'm trying to block that light. Boom. In the meantime, I'm going to just enjoy this new day, enjoy the new plans for the day, and, oh, you know what I can do? Yay! Okay, so I realized that I'm gonna make some road art gifts for, some of my family. Like, I've been on the news a couple times, and, I mean, not, like, in the newspaper and stuff, and so my mom is gonna send out little Christmas letters to all the relatives with the copies of the article or something, and so I thought I would send them road art, and so that'll be fun today too, like since I'm just gonna be sitting around all watching this. This is gonna send them, like, I thought maybe I should make them have peppering smiles or whatever, but then I would be kind of, you know, I would never get to see them again unless I go visit my relatives way out of state, which odds are I'm not gonna do if I don't travel well, you know. And so anyway, I thought, oh, I know what to do. I know what, because in the last article that I was in, they were mentioned that I have a project that might take years to complete, which is true. I am working on a project that might take years to complete. That, odds are, no, it already has taken years, and I'm not even close to completion of it, which I'm trying to make 1,000 flowers, but I thought, well, maybe I should make 1,000 and, like, 5 or 6 flowers, because I should send some to my relatives, because they'll be fun. So, like, I'm trying to show you what. Okay, so this is a road art flower, okay? So, it's just a flower made out of wires. Something stuck onto the vector. So I have, like, I'm trying to make 1,000 of these, and then one day after I make 1,000, then I'll go, I'll go out at night guess I'll do it in my major haunts. Oh, see, I was looking for one. My mom really likes lavender, and so I thought I had a purple flower, but I'm not seeing it. I know I have one with, oh, the silver one is pretty too. Yeah. I mean, all these things, like, some of them are kind of weird shaped. Like, you know, you just do whatever feels right. But anyway, okay, so looks like I'm going to be choosing some flowers to send to my relatives, and I'll be making some art. Oh, I need to work on this guy. I think I'm going to take him all apart and start all over completely over, because sometimes I get picky about my road art stuff. Here's some more flowers. I need to count them all and stuff anyway. Like, my point is, there's a million, oh my girl, there's a million things I should do and I can do and I will do, since my footrest is falling off on my chair. But as the TED Talk I was watching this morning points out, adaptability is such a major important part of life and of happiness and the ability. It's survival of the fittest, but it truly is the fittest. It's the fittest for your environment, the fittest for whatever situation presents itself. So, I'm gonna work on all this stuff. Oh yeah, that's a point. The point of looking in the road in this bucket was to get, see, this is another thing I can work on. This, she's a girl. She's a girl that goes with these lips. And, she's got eyes around here somewhere too, but I don't know where they are at the moment. Here's one eye. And let me find the other eyes. Oh, yeah, and I need this stuff, too. Okay, so what do you know? Today is going to be a fun day. Because my footrest fell off. Prior to this, it was going to be a get stuff done day. Now it's going to be a fun day. So, hey, thank you, footrest. Oh, I'm still gonna get stuff done. Yes, I know, I still have to work on stuff. Yes, I am aware of that. But, in the meantime, I can't do it with a broken footrest, right? Like, I mean, I kinda can. But, this will be fun. So, here I go. Such as my footrest falling off, because that means I get to play all day. So, what could be better than that? And, so, bye. My fingers just wiggle, and then it's hard to get them on there, and then sometimes I double tap. But anyway.